In this video, I'll be repeating Mr. Beast's name for 10 good minutes non-stop. I wish to get Mr. Beast's attention through this video and possibly get one of his donations. Please watch this video to the end and make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel so that you will not miss any of my upcoming videos. So let's get started. 3, 2, 1, 0.
Mr. Beast, 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 M Mr. Beast, 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 M
Mr. Beast. Wow, I did it.
Wow, that's really challenging. I'm so happy I completed it. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please, if you have any topic or any challenge you want me to make a video on, do comment below. Also, I wish to plead with you to support me and help me grow my channel. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell button. Thank you so much for watching my videos and see you next time. Top 10 profitable import and export business you can start in Africa. In this video, I'm going to show you the list of top 10 products you can import and export from Africa. I'm going to give you the guidelines on how to find genuine supplier, and finally, I'm going to show you how to avoid scam. Scam is one of the major problems in international business, especially in Africa. In this video, I'm going to show you how to identify a scammer and the best way to avoid them. Please watch this video to the end and subscribe to my YouTube channel. My name is Richard. The number one product is cashew nut. Raw cashew nut is a tropical product found mostly in West African countries. Countries like Nigeria, Ghana, Benin Republic, Togo, Ivory Coast, Tanzania, Guinea-Bissau, and so many others. Cashew nut is a very lucrative business. You can buy from any of these African countries and export it to China, Vietnam, and India. You can also process the raw cashew nut into kernel and export to European countries and America at a higher price. The cashew season in Africa starts in February and ends in June, July. The second product is wood. Timber business is a very nice business to start in Africa. With timber business, you can make a lot of profit within a short period of time. And it does not require a huge capital to start up with, like the cashew nut. In Africa, there's a lot of species of wood which you can start with. We have teak wood, we have rosewood, we have tali, we have paddock, we have koso, we have so many of them that you can deal with. The price of wood in Africa is cheaper than the price of wood in other parts of the world. Also, in Africa, you can get wood with a very big size. You can get wood of one log in a container, two logs in a container, or three logs in a container, which is very hard to find in other parts of the world. In terms of wood market, Vietnam and China has the highest wood market in the world. These are the two countries where you can export your wood and get it sold immediately without delay. They also have a very good payment system. Number three, peanut. Peanut is another product you can buy from Africa in a very cheap price and then export it to other parts of the world in a higher price. You can find peanuts in Nigeria, Burkina Faso, Ghana, South Sudan, Benin Republic, Togo, and so on. Peanuts has a very high demand in China, Indonesia, and some other Asia countries. Number four, cocoa. Cocoa is an agro product used in production of different things in industry. It can be found in a large quantity in Africa Coast, Ghana, and Nigeria. Cocoa has a very high demand in international markets with a very huge profit. You can buy cocoa in Africa at a very cheap price and export to other parts of the world. Number 4 is palm oil. Palm oil, also known as red oil, is another product you can buy in a cheap price from Africa and then export to other parts of the world in a higher price.
Other products you can export from Africa includes shea butter, ginger, cotton, and the charcoal. For importation, you can go into electronics, clothes, and the shoes. These are the products that move very well in Africa.
Now that you know the top 10 products you can import and export from Africa, the next thing is how to find genuine suppliers and avoid being scammed. Scam is one of the major problems in international business, especially in online business. We fail victim to scam as a result of being greedy and desperate. When you are greedy, looking for the cheapest price, you easily fail victim to those scammers because they will offer you the cheapest price you'll never get from another place, with the intention of getting your money. And once they get your money, you won't see them again. Secondly, when you are desperate over anything, you easily make mistakes without looking back. So the first step to avoid scam is don't be greedy and don't be desperate. The second point is don't pay deposits. Most of these scammers will ask you to pay some deposits as a way of showing your commitment in the business. They will even ask you to pay as low as 40% deposit and then pay the balance when you have received the goods. The truth here is that after you have paid the first deposit, they will start telling you stories. They will not deliver. They will tell you stories and ask you to pay more money. And at the end of the whole show, you will not receive your money and you will not receive the goods. So avoid making payment in advance to anyone. Instead of making payment in advance, make use of bank-to-bank transactions like DP and LOC. DP is Documents Against Payment, and LOC is Letter of Credit. It's a bank-to-bank transaction that is very, very secure for both the supplier and the buyer. When you use LOC transaction, you don't lose any money, except the charges you pay to the bank to open the LOC. Another means to avoid scam is through face-to-face transaction. Always try to meet the company or the individual you are buying goods from. With the face-to-face transaction, it's very, very hard for them to scam you because you will be there to check the quality of goods you are buying, to check the documents and any other necessary things that you need to check before making the payment. With the face-to-face transaction, you get to know each other. You get to know the company and the company gets to know you. And with time, you get to build a business relationship and trust. Finally, if you want to buy any product from Africa, or you want to sell your own product in Africa and you are looking for a business partner, an agent or a distributor, please leave a comment below and I will get back to you as soon as possible. If you enjoy watching this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and make sure you hit the bell button so that you don't miss any of my upcoming video. Thank you so much for watching my video. What is YouTube SubPostSub? Why do I lose subscribers after doing SubPostSub? And how can I get permanent subscribers through YouTube SubPostSub? If these are your questions, then stay tuned to this video. In this video, I'm going to show you step by step on how to do YouTube SubPostSub. I'm going to explain to you the reason why you lose your subscribers after doing SubPostSub. And the last year and the most important thing, I'm going to give you the guidelines on how to get genuine and the permanent subscribers through SubPostSub. Welcome to BBN. My name is Richard Ogunwu. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel and make sure you hit the bell button so that you will not miss any of my videos.
What is SubPostSub? SubPostSub stands for subscriber for subscriber. It is a mutual agreement between two people where they share their YouTube link and subscribe for each other. The main aim of SubPostSub is to help each other grow their respective YouTube channel and help them meet up with the YouTube monetization policy, which requires you to have 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 hours of view within the space of 12 months.
Now we know what is YouTube SubPostSub. And the next thing is where and how do you start SubPostSub.
To start Sub for Sub, you have to look for people who have similar interests, mostly new YouTubers who are looking for 1,000 subscribers to monetize their channel. The best place to get such people is Facebook. You log into your Facebook account and go to the search button. Then search for YouTube Sub for Sub. You will see a lot of groups there, so you join as many groups as you can, and then you can start your Sub for Sub. When you start doing Sub for Sub, you observe that most times you lose subscribers after doing Sub for Sub. You subscribe for 10 people and you will get only 5 or 6. You subscribe to 20 and you get only 10 or 15. So why do you lose subscribers after doing Sub for Sub? There are two reasons why you lose subscribers after doing Sub for Sub. Number one is YouTube spam. When someone subscribes to your channel without watching your videos, or subscribe to your channel after watching your video for a very short time, YouTube consider it as spam and remove the subscription automatically. Number two is fake subscribers. Some people will subscribe to your channel and later on unsubscribe you. That means the subscription will not be permanent. So now the question is, how do I get permanent subscribers? To get permanent subscribers, number one, don't do Sub for Sub without watch time. Some people will ask you to do Sub for Sub with them only to subscribe without watching your videos. Please don't do it. When you subscribe without watching the videos, the subscription will not be permanent because YouTube consider it as spam and remove it automatically. Number two is watch time. When you are doing Sub for Sub with anyone, try and negotiate with the person and let him watch your video for 2 good minutes before subscribing. The possibility is that when he watch your video for 2 minutes before subscribing, YouTube will not remove the subscription and then it will be permanent. The next point is having multiple Gmail accounts. When you have multiple Gmail accounts, it will help you to get so many subscribers within a short period of time. How does it work? When you go to Sub for Sub, you see a lot of guys who post 10 versus 10, 15 versus 15, 5 versus 5, and so on. That means that they have up to 10 Gmail accounts, and they can subscribe for you 10 times with different Gmail accounts. So if you have your own multiple accounts, like 10 Gmail accounts, you can also subscribe to them 10 Gmail with 10 Gmail accounts, and they will also use their own 10 Gmail account and subscribe to your channel. That makes this easier for you. So if you meet about 5 people who have 10 Gmail accounts, and all the 10 subscribe to you, you are going to get 50 subscribers within that short period of time. That's all I was doing this video on how to get permanent subscribers through Sub for Sub. Please, if you have any question, or you have any topic that you want me to make a video on, please do comment below. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel and make sure you hit the bell button so that you will not miss any of my videos. Thank you so much. In this video, I'll be repeating Mr. Beast's name for 10 good minutes non-stop. I wish to get Mr. Beast's attention through this video and possibly get one of his donations. Please watch this video to the end and make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel so that you will not miss any of my upcoming videos. So let's get started. 3, 2, 1, 0. Mr. Beast, 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 Mr. Beast,
Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, Mr. Beast, M
Mr. Beast. Wow, I did it.
Wow, that's really challenging. I'm so happy I completed it. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please, if you have any topic or any challenge you want me to make a video on, do comment below. Also, I wish to plead with you to support me and help me grow my channel. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell button. Thank you so much for watching my videos and see you next time. Top 10 profitable import and export business you can start in Africa. In this video, I'm going to show you the list of top 10 products you can import and export from Africa. I'm going to give you the guidelines on how to find genuine supplier. And finally, I'm going to show you how to avoid scam. Scam is one of the major problems in international business, especially in Africa. In this video, I'm going to show you how to identify a scammer and the best way to avoid them. Please watch this video to the end and subscribe to my YouTube channel. My name is Richard. The number one product is cashew nut. Raw cashew nut is a tropical product found mostly in West African countries. Countries like Nigeria, Ghana, Benin Republic, Togo, Ivory Coast, Tanzania, Guinea-Bissau, and so many others. Cashew nut is a very lucrative business. You can buy from any of these African countries and export it to China, Vietnam, and India. You can also process the raw cashew nut into kernel and export to European countries and America at a higher price. The cashew season in Africa starts in February and ends in June, July. The second product is wood. Timber business is a very nice business to start in Africa. With timber business, you can make a lot of profit within a short period of time. And it does not require a huge capital to start up with, like the cashew nut. In Africa, there's a lot of species of wood which you can start with. We have teak wood, we have rosewood, we have tali, we have paddock, we have koso, we have so many of them that you can deal with. The price of wood in Africa is cheaper than the price of wood in other parts of the world. Also, in Africa, you can get wood with a very big size. You can get wood of one log in a container, two logs in a container, or three logs in a container, which is very hard to find in other parts of the world. In terms of wood market, Vietnam and China has the highest wood market in the world. These are the two countries where you can export your wood and get it sold immediately without delay. They also have a very good payment system. Number three, peanuts. Peanut is another product you can buy from Africa in a very cheap price and then export it to other parts of the world in a higher price. You can find peanuts in Nigeria, Burkina Faso, Ghana, South Sudan, Benin Republic, Togo, and so on. Peanuts has a very high demand in China, Indonesia, and some other Asia countries. Number four, cocoa. Cocoa is an agro product used in production of different things in the industry. It can be found in a large quantity in Africa Coast, Ghana, and Nigeria. Cocoa has a very high demand in international markets with a very huge profit. You can buy cocoa in Africa at a very cheap price and export to other parts of the world. Number 4 is palm oil. Palm oil, also known as red oil, is another product you can buy in a cheap price from Africa and then export to other parts of the world in a higher price.
Other products you can export from Africa includes shea butter, ginger, cotton, and the charcoal. For importation, it can go into electronics, clothes, and the shoes. These are the products that move very well in Africa.
Now that you know the top 10 products you can import and export from Africa, the next thing is how to find genuine suppliers and avoid being scammed. Scam is one of the major problems in international business, especially in online business. We fail victim to scam as a result of being greedy and desperate. When you are greedy, looking for the cheapest price, you easily fail victim to those scammers because they will offer you the cheapest price you will never get from another place, with the intention of getting your money. And once they get your money, you won't see them again. Secondly, when you are desperate over anything, you easily make mistakes without looking back. So the first step to avoid scam is don't be greedy and don't be desperate. The second point is don't pay deposits. Most of these scammers will ask you to pay some deposits as a way of showing your commitment in the business. They will even ask you to pay as well as 40% deposit, and then pay the balance when you have received the goods. The truth here is that after you have paid the first deposit, they will start telling you stories. They will not deliver. They will tell you stories and ask you to pay more money. And at the end of the whole show, you will not receive your money and you will not receive the goods. So avoid making payment in advance to anyone. Instead of making payment in advance, make use of bank-to-bank transactions like DP and LOC. DP is Documents Against Payment, and LOC is Letter of Credit. It's a bank-to-bank transaction that is very, very secured for both the supplier and the buyer. When you use LOC transaction, you don't lose any money, except the money, the charges you pay to the bank to open the LOC. Another means to avoid scam is through face-to-face transaction. Always try to meet the company or the individual you are buying goods from. With the face-to-face transaction, it's very, very hard for them to scam you, because you will be there to check the quality of goods you are buying, to check the documents and any other necessary things that you need to check before making the payment. With the face-to-face transaction, you get to know each other. You get to know the company and the company gets to know you. And with time, you get to build a business relationship and trust. Finally, if you want to buy any product from Africa, or you want to sell your own product in Africa and you are looking for a business partner, an agent or a distributor, please leave a comment below and I will get back to you as soon as possible. If you enjoy watching this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and make sure you hit the bell button so that you don't miss any of my upcoming video. Thank you so much for watching my video. What is YouTube Sub for Sub? Why do I lose subscribers after doing Sub for Sub? And how can I get permanent subscribers through YouTube Sub for Sub? If these are your questions, then stay tuned to this video. In this video, I'm going to show you step by step on how to do YouTube Sub for Sub. I'm going to explain to you the reason why you lose your subscribers after doing Sub for Sub. And the last thing and the most important thing, I'm going to give you the guidelines on how to get genuine and the permanent subscribers through Sub for Sub. Welcome to BBN. My name is Richard Ogunwu. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel and make sure you hit the bell button so that you will not miss any of my videos.
What is Sub for Sub? Sub for Sub stands for subscriber for subscriber. It is a mutual agreement between two people where they share their YouTube link and subscribe for each other. The main aim of Sub for Sub is to help each other grow their respective YouTube channel and help them meet up with the YouTube monetization policy, which requires you to have 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 hours of view within the space of 12 months.
Now we know what is YouTube Sub for Sub. And the next thing is where and how do you start Sub for Sub.
To start Sub for Sub, you have to look for people who have similar interests, mostly new YouTubers who are looking for 1,000 subscribers to monetize their channel. The best place to get such people is Facebook. You log into your Facebook account and go to the search button. Then search for YouTube Sub for Sub. You will see a lot of groups there, so you join as many groups as you can, and then you can start your Sub for Sub. When you start doing Sub for Sub, you observe that most times you lose subscribers after doing Sub for Sub. You subscribe for 10 people and you will get only 5 or 6. You subscribe to 20 and you get only 10 or 15. So why do you lose subscribers after doing Sub for Sub? There are two reasons why you lose subscribers after doing Sub for Sub. Number one is YouTube spam. When someone subscribes to your channel without watching your videos, or subscribe to your channel after watching your video for a very short time, YouTube considers it as spam and remove the subscription automatically. Number two is fake subscribers. Some people will subscribe to your channel and later on unsubscribe you. That means the subscription will not be permanent. So now the question is, how do I get permanent subscribers? To get permanent subscribers, number one, don't do Sub for Sub without watch time. Some people will ask you to do Sub for Sub with them only to subscribe without watching your videos. Please don't do it. When you subscribe without watching the videos, the subscription will not be permanent because YouTube will consider it as spam and remove it automatically. Number two is watch time. When you are doing Sub for Sub with anyone, try and negotiate with the person and let him watch your video for 2 good minutes before subscribing. The possibility is that when he watch your video for 2 minutes before subscribing, YouTube will not remove the subscription and then it will be permanent. The next point is having multiple Gmail accounts. When you have multiple Gmail accounts, it will help you to get so many subscribers within a short period of time. How does it work? When you go to Sub for Sub, you see a lot of guys who post 10 versus 10, 15 versus 15, 5 versus 5, and so on. That means that they have up to 10 Gmail accounts and they can subscribe for you 10 times with different Gmail accounts. So if you have your own multiple accounts, like 10 Gmail accounts, you can also subscribe to them 10 Gmail with 10 Gmail accounts, and they will also use their own 10 Gmail accounts and subscribe to your channel. That makes this easier for you. So if you meet some, if you meet about 5 people who have 10 Gmail accounts, and all the 10 subscribe to you, you are going to get 50 subscribers within that short period of time. That's all I was today's video on how to get permanent subscribers through Sub for Sub. Please, if you have any question, or you have any topic that you want me to make a video on, please do comment below. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel and make sure you hit the bell button so that you don't miss any of my videos. Thank you so much. time profitable import and export business you can start in Africa. In this video, I'm going to show you the list of top 10 products you can import and export from Africa. I'm going to give you the guidelines on how to find genuine supplier. And finally, I'm going to show you how to avoid scam. Scam is one of the major problems in international business, especially in Africa. In this video, I'm going to show you how to identify a scammer and the best way to avoid them. Please watch this video to the end and subscribe to my YouTube channel. My name is Richard. The number one product is cashew nut. Raw cashew nut is a tropical product found mostly in West African countries. Countries like Nigeria, Ghana, Benin Republic, Togo, Ivory Coast, Tanzania, Guinea-Bissau, and so many others. Cashew nut is a very lucrative business. You can buy from any of these African countries and export it to China, Vietnam, and India. You can also process the raw cashew nut into kernel and export to European countries and America at a higher price. The cashew season in Africa starts in February and ends in June, July. The second product is wood. Timber business is a very nice business to start in Africa. With timber business, you can make a lot of profit within a short period of time. And it does not require a huge capital to start up with, like the cashew nuts. In Africa, there's a lot of species of wood which you can start with. We have teak wood, we have rosewood, we have tali, we have paddock, we have koso, we have so many of them that you can deal with. The price of wood in Africa is cheaper than the price of wood in other parts of the world. Also, in Africa, you can get wood with a very big size. You can get wood of one log in a container, two logs in a container, or three logs in a container, which is very, very hard to find in other parts of the world. In terms of wood market, Vietnam and China has the highest wood market in the world. These are the two countries where you can export your wood and get it sold immediately without delay. They also have a very good payment system. Number three, peanuts. Peanut is another product you can buy from Africa in a very cheap price and then export it to other parts of the world in a higher price. You can find peanuts in Nigeria, Burkina Faso, Ghana, South Sudan, Benin Republic, Togo, and so on. Peanuts has a very high demand in China, Indonesia, and some other Asia countries. Number four, cocoa. Cocoa is an agro product used in production of different things in industry. It can be found in a large quantity in Africa Coast, Ghana, and the Nigeria. Cocoa has a very high demand in international markets with a very huge profit. You can buy cocoa in Africa at a very cheap price and export to other parts of the world. Number four is palm oil. Palm oil, also known as red oil, is another product you can buy in a cheap price from Africa and then export to other parts of the world in a higher price.
Other products you can export from Africa includes shea butter, ginger, cotton, and the charcoal. For importation, you can go into electronics, clothes, and the shoes. These are the products that move very well in Africa.
Now that you know the top 10 products you can import and export from Africa, the next thing is how to find genuine suppliers and avoid being scammed. Scam is one of the major problems in international business, especially in online business. We fail victim to scam as a result of being greedy and desperate. When you are greedy, looking for the cheapest price, you easily fail victim to those scammers because they will offer you the cheapest price you'll never get from another place, with the intention of getting your money. And once they get your money, you won't see them again. Secondly, when you are desperate over anything, you easily make mistakes without looking back. So the first step to avoid scam is don't be greedy and don't be desperate. The second point is don't pay deposits. Most of these scammers will ask you to pay some deposits as a way of showing your commitment in the business. They will even ask you to pay as well as 40% deposit, and then pay the balance when you have received the goods. The truth here is that after you have paid the first deposit, they will start telling you stories. They will not deliver. They will tell you stories and ask you to pay more money. And at the end of the whole show, you will not receive your money and you will not receive the goods. So avoid making payment in advance to anyone.
Instead of making payments in advance, make use of bank-to-bank transactions like DP and LOC. DP is Documents Against Payment, and LOC is Letter of Credit. It's a bank-to-bank transaction that is very, very secure for both the supplier and the buyer. When you use LOC transaction, you don't lose any money, except the money, the charges you pay to the bank to open the LOC.
Another means to avoid scam is through face-to-face transaction. Always try to meet the company or the individual you are buying goods from. With the face-to-face transaction, it's very, very hard for them to scam you, because you will be there to check the quality of goods you are buying, to check the documents and any other necessary things that you need to check before making the payment. With the face-to-face transaction, you get to know each other. You get to know the company, and the company gets to know you. And with time, you get to build a business relationship and trust. Finally, if you want to buy any product from Africa, or you want to sell your own product in Africa, and you are looking for a business partner, an agent, or a distributor, please leave a comment below and I will get back to you as soon as possible. If you enjoy watching this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and make sure you hit the bell button so that you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. Thank you so much for watching my video.
What is YouTube SupperSub? Why do I lose subscribers after doing SupperSub? And how can I get permanent subscribers through YouTube SupperSub? If these are your questions, then stay tuned to this video. In this video, I'm going to show you step by step on how to do YouTube SupperSub. I'm going to explain to you the reason why you lose your subscribers after doing SupperSub. And the last year and the most important thing, I'm going to give you the guidelines on how to get genuine and the permanent subscribers through SupperSub.
Welcome to BBN. My name is Richard Ogunwu. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel and make sure you hit the bell button so that you don't miss any of my videos.
What is SupperSub? SupperSub stands for subscriber for subscriber. It is a mutual agreement between two people or more, where they share their YouTube link and subscribe for each other. The main aim of SupperSub is to help each other grow their respective YouTube channel and help them meet up with the YouTube monetization policy, which requires you to have 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 hours of view within the space of 12 months.
Now you know what is YouTube SupperSub. And the next thing is, where and how do you start SupperSub? To start SupperSub, you have to look for people who have similar interests, mostly new YouTubers who are looking for 1,000 subscribers to monetize their channel. The best place to get such people is Facebook. You log into your Facebook account and go to the search button. Then search for YouTube SupperSub. You will see a lot of groups there, so you join as many groups as you can, and then you can start your SupperSub. When you start doing SupperSub, you will observe that most times you lose subscribers after doing SupperSub. You subscribe for 10 people and you will get only 6. You subscribe to 20 and you get only 10 or 15. So why do you lose subscribers after doing SupperSub? There are two reasons why you lose subscribers after doing SupperSub. Number one is YouTube spam. When someone subscribes to your channel without watching your videos, or subscribe to your channel after watching your video for a very short time, YouTube consider it as spam and remove the subscription automatically. Number two is fake subscribers. Some people will subscribe to your channel and later on unsubscribe you. That means the subscription will not be permanent. So now the question is, how do I get permanent subscribers? To get permanent subscribers, number one, don't do SupperSub without watch time. Some people will ask you to do SupperSub with them only to subscribe without watching your videos. Please don't do it. When you subscribe without watching the videos, the subscription will not be permanent, because YouTube will consider it as spam and remove it automatically. Number two is watch time. When you are doing SupperSub with anyone, try and negotiate with the person and let him watch your video for 2 good minutes before subscribing. The possibility is that when he watch your video for 2 minutes before subscribing, YouTube will not remove the subscription, and then it will be permanent. The next point is having multiple Gmail accounts. When you have multiple Gmail accounts, it will help you to get so many subscribers within a short period of time. How does it work? When you go to SupperSub, you see a lot of guys who post 10 versus 10, 15 versus 15,
5 verses 5 and so on. That means that they have up to 10 Gmail accounts and they can subscribe for you 10 times with different Gmail accounts. So if you have your own multiple accounts, like 10 Gmail accounts, you can also subscribe to them 10 Gmail with 10 Gmail accounts, and they will also use their own 10 Gmail account and subscribe to your channel. That makes this easier for you. So if you meet some, if you meet about 5 people who have 10 Gmail accounts, and all the 10 subscribe to you, you are going to get 50 subscribers within that short period of time. That's all I was going to read on how to get permanent subscribers through SubForSub. Please, if you have any question or you have any topic that you want me to make a video on, please do comment below. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel and make sure you hit the bell button so that you don't miss any of my videos. Thank you so much.